Hi, Tammy Sharice Walker. Happy New Year 2020. Can you believe it? This is so cool. Just to be in the land of the living, it's a beautiful thing. We have so much to be thankful for. Even if 2019 wasn't what we thought it should be, even if we don't have everything we want, many of us watching have everything we need. If you have food, clothing, shelter, family, friends, good health, income, you're winning. Team winning. Before I get started, if you are a new subscriber, welcome to my lovely channel. If you are a return viewer, welcome again. And for both parties, please, please hit like. This helps to get my videos circulating and get them to the top of that Google search so I can grow, grow, grow. Speaking of growing, I know you have set your resolutions. Some people, we do goals. Either way, you're probably wondering why by March or April, these things have fallen by the wayside. What is it that people are doing that are actually meeting their goals and resolutions versus people who fall off or honestly never get started? So, thought you'd never ask? Stay tuned. We're going to get into it. I really hope something I say will help you get your 2020 off the ground and into the sky. Visualize an airplane taking off at the runway, going up into the sky, and you're just killing it. Your dreams. You're going to do it. You're going to do it. But I want to leave you with some tips that can help you make your dreams come true. Let's go. Buying something you cannot afford to pay for. Tap into it. Hey there, welcome back. This video is about why your New Year's resolutions or goals may not be working. I will leave you some tips to help you get them to working. And again, if you're new to my channel, please hit subscribe. And for my return viewers, hit like, as well as my new subscribers. Everybody, hit like for me. Thank you so much. Okay, so it's a new year. It's 2020. 2019 is behind us. The truth of the matter is, just because the calendar flipped, it doesn't mean all of our cares and problems are gone away. But I was thinking, wouldn't that be awesome if 2019 is gone, 2020 comes, and all your debt is gone? Woo-wee! That would be amazing. But in reality, it's still with you. However, many of us, we write down goals, we have these great resolutions, and we're rah, 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 we're gung-ho. And I want to believe in my heart that everyone is feeling sincere, most of us, about our goals and resolutions. We really want them to happen, but some of us just simply don't know how to get the ball in motion. So tip number one, the reason why your goals are not working are because you do not have them ingrained in you. You have to eat, sleep, and breathe those goals. It's easy to say, 2020, I am going to stop smoking. In 2020, I will lose 20 pounds. In 2020, I will travel more. Next thing you know, it's October 2020, and you haven't done anything you said. And the reason is because you haven't ingrained that goal in you, that resolution. You have to work on it. I mean, a lot. You really do. And to say it is nice, but maybe write it down. And write it down often, almost like a punishment. I will not chew gum. I will not chew gum. I will lose 20 pounds. I will lose 20 pounds until you have that in your memory bank. We are creatures of habit. And it's easy to say what you want, but how does one, you know, put the work in and get it done? That's the key. Write it down. I write down my goals a lot of days, most days. I'm writing every day. And especially when I'm at work, I'm writing. And in the morning, what I do, I get up, I make my coffee, I take my vitamin B12, I take my D3, 3 and my probiotic, and I have my notebook on my kitchen table with my positive books, The Power of Positive Thinking, my Bible. This is a routine. I'm writing down goals, intentions. I'm writing down positive things. So give it a try. Get you a little notebook from the dollar store or wherever and write it down. Keep it in your purse. I have a big purse. I have it in my purse. Or if you have a backpack like me, I put it in there as well. And I'm often referring to it. This truly works. I know technology is great. You can text it to yourself. You can do the post-it note on your phone. You know how they have all this modern stuff. That's cool. Whatever works for you. I'm an old-fashioned girl. Pen to the paper, it really, truly works. So give it a try. Even those index cards, that's another good thing to put it on. Also, visualize while you're writing, when you go take a shower, when you're using the washroom, visualize yourself exercising on that treadmill, on the elliptical, losing your 20 pounds. Visualize yourself opening up your new business. Visualize. Do that over and over along with the writing down the resolutions and goals, and you will begin to embody those goals. In addition to writing it down, you have to put action behind it. I can write down, I want to pass my LSW, which is the license for a social worker. I can write that down all day, every day. If I don't get on that computer and do those practice tests or do those quizzes on my phone, I'm not going to pass anything. And to give you an example of how I wrote it down and put an action behind it, I've been off work now since the 24th. And I wrote down on the 23rd, December 23rd, I will study for my LSW. I said I will do it. I wrote down these different dates. So sure enough, as of yesterday, I did the practice exam of 170 questions and I scored 77. I need 70% to pass. So I was quite happy. Now I want to get more than 77. I want to get into the 80s and 90s, but I did do what I wrote down and I did do an action plan. I did it. So write it down, visualize. That's all one tip. Number two, you got to put action behind writing it down. And I've had people say this year, I want my own business. I'm not going to work for anybody. I got to have my own business. That's really good, but you got to have a plan. So if you want to work for yourself, you need to be in your car driving Uber. And you can make $400 through $1,000 a week or more. I made $400 to $500 part-time, like maybe 25, 30 hours. Imagine if you did 40, you could easily make $1,000. Got to have a plan. It's easy to say, I want my own business, but it's hard to have your own business. It takes hard work. I believe it's harder to work for yourself than someone else because you have to be self-motivated. No manager is going to tell you what to do, but it's a beautiful thing. And if that's what you want, it's beautiful. But, you know, it's easy to make our mouth say something, but to get up at the crack of dawn, to do your business plan, to meet with investors, to meet with different people, that takes great energy. So make sure you put action behind your goals and resolutions. That's tip number two, action, action. And let's see, number three, talk to someone that is an event planner, that is a hairstylist that owns their own salon, that is a personal trainer. One thing about that, people that are already into their field or they have their own company, they love to talk to you. I'm a life coach. I'm a therapist. I've had people say, what do I need to do to become a social worker? More so, what do I need to do to become a life coach? I've talked to them on the phone. I've met with people in person to guide them along the way. I don't have any problem sharing information. And I just want people to get away from that fear that someone's going to take business from you or that's my competition. You know, when you become successful and knowledgeable, share the wealth. Don't worry about competition. This world is so big, so much money here, so much energy and abundance. We don't have to be stingy and close-handed. We can open up our hand and grab a hand and help someone. That's really important. So that's what you need to do. Reach out to mentors and people already in that field and get up under them and check and study your competition. That's another thing. Study your competition, get your mentor, and Inquire. That's important to network. That's basically all I'm trying to say, network. That's tip number three. Tip number four, work on your resolution or your goal every day, every week. You know, this is my routine. Get up in the morning, make my coffee. I take my vitamin B, D, and probiotic. I put my notebook on my table, and I have my Bible and positive books, and I set intentions and goals, and I do this often, and it truly works. So I want you to get into it every day. If you want to lose weight, do some exercise, maybe top of the morning, maybe after work, daily. Or, you know, you don't want to say, I'm going to work out 7 days a week. You're probably not if you've been sitting on a couch. Start with two. But every day you can set your plan and say, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to eat a salad for lunch. I'm not going to drink pop. Whatever it is you need to do, do it daily and weekly. You got to make it a part of you, because to say I want to lose 20 pounds is easy, but to do it, it takes discipline, work, motivation, and tenacity, okay? Tip number six, last but not least. It's good to have deadlines, but be cool on the deadlines. You don't have to hit them on the head. If you say I'm going to lose 20 pounds by May 30th, and it's May 30th, you've lost 12, it's still all good. If your blood pressure is down, you're sleeping better, you're concentrating better, all is not lost. Sometimes things don't go the way we want them to go, when we want them to go. How many people create movies and they want the movie out by December 20th of 2020 and it gets pushed back to March 2021? These things happen. You want to be easy with your deadlines. I know a lot of times us women, we want to be married by this, we want to have these kids by this, and when things don't go as planned, we freak out. You know, you may not have the baby by 38, but maybe it'll be 39 or 40. Maybe you won't get to have kids. Maybe you'll marry somebody with kids. It's always going to be, you know, something else that could happen that could still turn out great. So try not to freak out when things don't go as planned or as you think they should go. Just know that if you're working on your goals, you're working on your resolution, you're bettering yourself, you're staying focused on your goals and resolutions, you're putting actions behind it, you know that something will happen. And in the midst of all of this stuff, you gotta have faith, and please, please stay positive. Don't go down the negative train. Try to avoid negative people. And it's a lot of people there. They're fear-based. And you can tell, listen to how they talk. They freak out about everything. And when something happens that's outside of their plans, they freak out. They're all humdrum, negative. They always know how something's going to turn out before it turns out. And it can start, you know, if you're the type that's anxious, it can jump on you and make you panic. You might be feeling good about it. They say something, you start freaking out. So for 2020, be protective of your energy, your space, your sanity, your dreams. You know, just get within yourself and focus on you. And when you do that, you're going to see some beautiful things happen. It's a lot of things out here to distract us. It's a lot of people to distract us. But to reach your goals, to reach your resolutions, one must really go inward. You really have to. That's what I got for you all. I'm excited about 2020 for you. I'm excited about 2020 for me. More importantly, I'm grateful to be alive. We don't have to be here, but we are. And, you know, drop me some comments about what you have planned for 2020, and I would love to hear. As always, thank you for watching. Like, and I'll be back with more information for you. Have a beautiful 2020. Get ready. It's going to be great.